Thank you, Lord, for so much. Major shout out to my boy K-Ray. Appreciate you with the video response I did on the video when I was talking about Tupac. And you know, bro, you was pointing out some great things in the video, K-Ray. And a shout out to the whole YouTube family. Most of all, shout out to God. And I love what you were saying when you got to talking about the smoking and the drinking, the liquor and the women. You know, Tupac, you know, smoked and drank. You know, it's a lot of people right now smoke and drink. And you know what? That's what the biggest confusion is also, man, nowadays. Because this is why the church folks always got a problem in the world. And this is why the people in the world always got a problem with the church folks. Why you say that, bro? Why you say that? Why you say that? Let me tell you why. And I know I'm finna make 1,500,000 deacons mad when I say this. But everybody, let me just say this off top. Everybody ain't bad and everybody ain't doing wrong in the church. And people in the world ain't all that bad like you think they are. And really ain't nobody better than nobody, to just be honest, because all of us really ain't no good. And I mean that in a good way. Because God say, Jesus said, you call no man good but the Father. And y'all know what I'm talking about. Now, I always hear people all the time, especially folks in church, talking about how bad people in the world smoke and drink. They cuss. They run women. Now, I'm finna bust on half of these deacons. Maybe y'all know some, or maybe it's just me. Now, you got these deacons, just like Mitty Man was saying. They keep their liquor in their back pocket. They drink liquor, bourbon. They smoke weed. They smoke cigarettes. They cuss folks out, and they run hoes. Y'all think I'm lying? Hey, I'll tell you the truth. These deacons do the same thing as folks in the world. And ain't just the deacons. I know some preachers like this. So what is your point, JT? I'm not even trying to make no point. All I'm saying is that people in the world do the same thing as these so-called unquote born again, holding and down, supposed to be Christians do. And K-Ray, you was telling the truth. Because Tupac, once again, one thing about Tupac, he didn't hide what he did. He came out real to the world with everything. And you know another reason why I like Tupac, bro, and I was looking at what Orange Flavor was saying in his comment. Tupac taught a lot of men how to respect women. Oh yeah. You look at his lyrics. He respected women. He might have had some few words that he said in so many songs, but Tupac did a song, old song called Keep Your Head Up. It wasn't nothing but positive. You remember, if you go even deeper than that, K-Ray, Tupac had a song called Brenda's Got a Baby. But Brenda's got a birdie, but Brenda's barely got a brain. He said a damn shame the girl can hardly spell her name. To me, that song never got old, man. It never got old. Brenda's Got a Baby. And then he did songs like Keep Your Head Up, Dear Mama. Tupac was crying out for love, man, and help. He even said, I wonder if heaven got a ghetto. And I told Tupac one time in the spirit, I said, heaven ain't got no ghetto, but I knew what he meant. I said, there is a hell, but there ain't no ghetto. Because ain't nothing going up there ghetto-ish. He tells us that in scripture. But you can feel what Pac was saying. And he made such great points. Told you how to respect women. Oh, man. I wish we could understand about people in the world, man, because real talk, you ain't that far from the world, and some of y'all still in the world. Talk to myself first, on down. That's why I don't hide nothing I do. I don't hide behind nothing. I am who I am, because I keep telling people that was the whole point of the scripture when it says you was born in sin, shaped in what? Iniquity. God gonna forever be pulling on you to pull something out of you that you was born with. And people wonder why they can't get rid of this, why they can't get rid of that, because God gonna forever be working on you. You ever notice? Let's just look at it like this. I'm gonna make a valid point. Let's take somebody that used to shoot dope up their arm. They finally stopped shooting dope, but they crave cigarettes. They get rid of one habit, but then they find themselves getting another habit. knowing that cigarettes can cause lung cancer and you still can die. But they look at it like this, well, I ain't shooting that needle up my arm no more. But you're still punishing your body. Man, you got a lot of folks wanting to talk bad about people in the world, man. See, I keep doing these videos for a reason. We are outreaching. I ain't in reaching because I can't reach nobody in the church. They saved already, according to them. They holding it down. We can't tell them nothing. Because I got a new flag for you. A whole lot of these folks in church ain't never done nothing for me but made me pissed off. And I'm talking about a lot of churches I done been. I ain't talking about no one in particular. I'm talking about many churches because tradition done divided us up and religion done divided us up. That's why the young folks can't be reached. Oh man, smoking and drinking. That just only apply to people in the world. See, somebody gonna get mad at this video because once again, the truth is out. Man, I know some deacons that'll drink you under the table, go hang out with them. And they'll still be up early in the morning, Sunday morning on their post. Yeah, some of them gonna be there halfway drunk. The older deacons like to run the young women. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. Some of them married, some ain't, but they still running women. Look at some of these pastors running women, getting busted, smoking and drinking. I gotta hang with. I gotta look like God on Sunday, but be like the world on Monday. Hiding behind Christianity, using that for. We want to use Jesus as a cover up. Oh yeah, we gonna hide behind Christianity. We want to use being a Christian as a cover up because it's easy to fool somebody else. When you look at it, how you ain't fooling God. You ain't fooling God. You can't run, care how far you run, how far you drive away. You God right there looking at you, wondering what's wrong with you. But we quick to talk about the people that's smoking and drinking. Like we said, K-Ray Tupac was very positive, man, on a lot of things. I can look and listen to Tupac. Sometimes I can see Tupac and say, man, all these folks that call themselves holier than thou, I would rather hang with Tupac than to hang with a holier than thou person. Uh-oh. Why? Because Tupac would have kept it real. It would be my destiny to be lonely. Love that cat, man. Brought a lot of knowledge. That's what I call a true lyricist, man. A rapper that could, oh man, just lay it down like cards on the table. Lay it down like cards on the table. And we can't look past what people do once again. And I'm just using this to make you think and look at something. Look at these deacons. Matter of fact, let's turn on the news. Let's look at the internet and see what's all blowed up now. It ain't the people in the world all the time. It's the church folks now. I did a video a long time ago saying, who look worse now? The church folks or the people in the world? That goes to show you, man. Ain't nobody better than nobody. And what do that also show you? Ain't nobody perfect. Why? People in the world cuss. Church folks cuss. Oh, yeah. Oh, but I don't ever see them cuss. Well, you ain't around them. See, if you was like me and be around all this stuff all the time, like I was saying, when you be in and out of the studio, and you can be, man, some folks can go to their own church, and you see folks cussing out folks on the church ground, fights in the church. See, people think everything I talk about, I be lying about it. No, I be telling the God truth. This is what done happened in every church I done been at pretty much. I ain't gonna call no names. Folks is acting stupid and ignorant in church nowadays. Cussing folks out, fighting. I'm talking about physically fighting. And you look at the people in the world, they be like, okay, why would we even come to church? Oh man, you know who reached out to Tupac? The streets. The streets reached out to him. That's why I say, and I'm going to say this again, I know y'all tired of me talking about this, begging for money and this prosperity, all this stuff to make everybody else rich, like the preachers. But we can't reach out. Bring all the tithes to the storehouse. Want to keep going back to Malachi. And these so-called storehouses ain't even helping nobody. Who the storehouse now? These churches. Who receiving the money? The preacher. Not the widow women. Not the orphans. Not the homeless people. They still homeless. I can go on the other side of town and see homeless people sleeping in front of the church. Oh, can I keep it real? Church won't even open the damn door. Oh, leave them out there asleep. Don't worry about giving them nothing to eat. Well, we would give all the money to the pastor, but we won't even give a homeless man 50 cents. Won't even make him a damn sandwich. This is sad, y'all. But we want to talk about the gangsters, the people in the world, the smoking and the drinking, the thugs, the clubbing. I told you, man, church look just like the club nowadays. Club don't, some of the clubs don't let out, they let out late, church let out late. Can we keep it all the way real? You pay to get in, you go to church, you pay to get in. Except the church, they ask you for more money. Oh man, I just try to keep it real. They beg for money all night, and you don't never see where the money going. Except when the pastor pull up in his new car. And I don't hate on no pastor. I'm here to say, I'm not here to knock no way up that God blesses anybody. But I'm telling you the dirty side of what's going on. Y'all see it. The preacher being prosperous, but the church ain't. And the folks in the church struggling. But we want to sit here and talk about drinking and smoking. People in the world terrible, they bad. And y'all just the same as the people in the world. So I tell people, the drinking is not the sin, it's the drunkenness. Sex ain't bad, it's the way we done took it and did it all the wrong way. The way God say don't do it. Money ain't bad, it's the love of money that's the root of all evil. But what we doing with these scriptures? Prosperity ain't just about money. But some folks ain't gonna never get that. Too many people too busy looking good. What good is looking good gonna do? You can look like $1 million and be broken toe up on the inside of your body. Broken up in all kind of pieces. Your heart is just in bad shape. Your spirit is in bad shape. So what good is looking good gonna do? Have all the nice things in the world, what good is that gonna do if you don't have eternal salvation? And I'm gonna say this before I get out of here once again. You can't hook up no U-Haul truck and take it to heaven, nor hell. So think about that when you leave here. God bless.